Hi everybody, welcome to a special episode of On the Spectrum Kitchen. Today is the 88th anniversary of the release of the Three Stooges short, Uncivil Warriors. And there's a scene where Curly mistakes a heating pad for a layer of cake, and the Stooges ended up eating a cake that was and it ended up with them coughing up feathers. Don't worry, this won't contain any feathers. But I am going to make that same cake that they made, minus the feathers. And I'm not exactly sure what flavor it was, but my best bet is that it was a vanilla cake with vanilla frosting. But I know for a fact it was made with strawberry preserves in the center for the filling. All right, let's get baking. All right, so first things first, we're going to start on the dry ingredients. Now, we are going to start with 3 cups of all-purpose flour. I'm not going to use a sieve today. I thought I'd do something a little different. Next, we'll need 1 tablespoon of baking powder. Just want to scrape off. Sorry, I'm doing it off camera. Next, we are going to add 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. I honestly don't even know what the difference is between baking powder and baking soda, but when used together, I guess it helps with the leavening process. Here you go. And now we're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Now we're going to whisk and combine. Okay, I am so sorry about the interruption. That was my cat. I guess that was his way of telling me he wants to be in this video. Alright, so anyway, now that we are done with the dry ingredients, we're just going to whisk them up until combined. You don't have to mix them up forever, just give it like a good, I don't know, 10, 15 seconds. All right, we're gonna set this aside. Next, we're gonna go on to wet ingredients. Now, you're gonna need 2 sticks or 1 cup of softened, unsalted butter. 1.5 cups of granulated sugar. 1/2 cup of vegetable oil. If you don't have vegetable oil, a good substitute is canola oil. Alright, set that aside. Next, we are going to grab an electric whisk or stand mixer, and we are going to beat these ingredients together until combined. This is what you're going for. It doesn't have to be totally mixed, and it's totally okay if it looks creamy like this. We're going to add more ingredients. All right, next, we are going to add 4 room temperature eggs, 1 at a time, and we are going to beat within each addition. Let me show you what I mean. Egg, and then combine. Turn this off so you can hear me. You don't have to do a long mixing process. You just gotta make sure it is beaded well enough. Egg number 3, which is a little, make sure you crack them hard enough, but not too hard. It'll get everywhere. All right, now we're gonna mix. And And when I say mixed, I meant beat. I meant to say beat. My apologies. Okay, last egg. Now, finally, we are going to slowly add the flour mixture along with 1 cup of milk. And then we are going to get to the final mixing process. Now, if you don't feel comfortable doing the shaking because you're afraid everything's going to fall out, that's okay. Simply grab a spoon or a spatula, like this one, and slowly put it in. Now, you don't have to do it extremely slow, like turtle slow, just not too fast either. Kind of like this. Can you see how I'm doing it? This is a slow top of that. You can also tap it a little bit. Now it's time to add the 1 cup of milk. Carefully pick it up and slowly add it in like this. I guess how you put in the remaining ingredients makes a huge difference with the batter baking time, apparently. That's just a guess. I'm going to do research a little later. Once you start running out, you can speed it up just a smidge. Alright. And finally, we're gonna get our batter. It's time to mix until combined. I forgot to add the most important ingredient. Vanilla. My bad. All right, you just take 1 tablespoon of vanilla extract, and then you stir until combined.
This is what the batter is supposed to look like. I am so sorry that I forgot to add the vanilla. When you do add the vanilla, make sure you do that before you add the flour and the milk, but do it right after you beat in all the eggs.
Now, time to fill up our cake pans.
All right, we are gonna carefully add it in, not all of it, because this cake pan is not so big. You can use either 8-inch or a 10-inch cake pan. Look at that beautiful consistency. And we're gonna smooth it out a little bit. Make sure you prep your cake pans with cooking spray like Pam and parchment paper. I'm using aluminum foil today because I'm out of parchment paper, sadly. That's an easy improvision. Don't use plastic wrap. I'm afraid the plastic wrap will start a fire. Okay. I'm gonna add just a little bit more. Maybe a scoopful, 2 or more. In the edges. Make sure you smooth it out a little bit. I forgot to mention this. That's actually why I'm doing it. So the top can help with the baking process. Okay, now on to the second cake pan. You can use either 2 cake pans, 3. Heck, if you have a big enough one, you could do 1. Missing some, that's okay. You don't have to get all of it. Sorry, I repeated it because I wasn't sure if you heard me. Great. Now, kind of gently smooth it out. All right. Right now, remember when I used these cake strips for my Boston cream pie? Well, I'm going to use them for the vanilla cake. It's important that you rinse them under cold water to help it flatten. The cake, I mean. And make sure you wring it out so it's not too wet. And if you have the clip or a paper or a clothespin, my apologies. Push in gently. So it'll look like that. Now, the cakes are finally gonna go into the oven. Before we get started, preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Gently place both cakes in the oven. And we are going to bake both cakes for about 30 minutes. But depending on how powerful your oven is, I recommend watching like a hawk. Alright, now the cakes are almost done. Alright, the cakes are almost done. Now we're going to get to the strawberry preserves. First, we're going to need 4 cups of strawberries that are hulled. Hulled means that the center and the leaves are cut off. Kind of like this. You can use a knife, a strawberry corer, a straw. I use an apple corer. Worked out well, except for a couple, but. All right. Add the strawberries. Next, we're going to add 4 cups of sugar. Don't worry, this has been pre-measured. And next, we're gonna add 1 lemon that's been juiced. I separated from the seeds. We're gonna add them all in a large sauce pot. And we're gonna bring it to a rapid boil. And we're gonna stir, and this should take like 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, so one of the cakes finished early. I just wanted to show you what it looked like. Smells really good. You can really smell the vanilla. Alright, so we're going to let... Once they're both out of the oven, or one of them's out of the oven, we're going to put them in the fridge for a little bit until they cook. Okay, so real quick, I wanted to show you what the strawberry preserves look like. Well, they're still cooking. They take about 15 to 20 minutes. This is supposed to be what it looks like. Just thought I'd show you that. Something I forgot to mention twice, unfortunately, and I apologize for that. While cooking the strawberry preserves, the strawberries will be breaking apart, but that is okay. That's actually what we need. It'll help bite through the preserves a lot easier. All right, now I'm gonna test to see if the preserves are done. A way to do this is take a metal spoon, dip it in, and run it against your finger. And if the jam doesn't resurface, that means it's done. Or the preserve, my apologies. It's a little hot, so. I don't see resurfacing, so I guess it's done. All right, well, the cake and the filling is cooling. It's time to make the frosting. All right, now it's time for the frosting. So first off, we're gonna add 2 sticks or 1 cup of unsalted butter that has been softened. All right. And we are going to beat it for a couple of minutes until it's pale and fluffy. See, it should look like this. That's how pale and fluffy you want it. All right, next, we're gonna add 2 cups of powdered sugar. Now, it's important that you sift the powdered sugar, otherwise your frosting will be covered in clumps. I learned that the hard way. All right, now we're gonna beat the powdered sugar and butter until combined.
Okay.
All right, now it's halfway combined. We'll lift up the camera to see what we got. Now this is what you want to start with. We're about to add the rest now. We are gonna add 1.5 teaspoons of vanilla extract. Now that the powder, the vanilla extract's added, we are gonna beat again until combined. All right. Now, when I said beat, I meant to say mix. I apologize. Now we're gonna have stuff on the side, but that's okay. You just take a spatula or a spoon and you simply just scoop it to the center where it's easy. And now we are gonna add 2 tablespoons of whole milk. Sorry, my arm got in the way there. Now we are going to mix one more time and then it'll be fully combined. We are looking for in a frosting. All right, now we're gonna fill the frosting with in a piping bag. Here, this is what I did. I grabbed a piping bag, a reusable one that I own, and I put it in a cookie jar that was a gift from a friend. This is gonna help keep the bag still while I fill. Here, this is the consistency you're looking for in a frosting. Gently do this to get it in. All right, it should take like a few scoops. You're gonna wanna use a spatula or a large enough and flat enough spoon. Let's do this. Now, this always gets tricky, so don't get frustrated. If you don't have anything large enough to put your piping bag in, or a piping bag in, ask for some help. Ask a parent or a friend, whoever is closest to you. In the house, not. Okay, here we go. Oopsie. Now, it is time to frost the cake and to fill. All right, so I'm gonna be sitting down for this next part. Now we are going to assemble our cake. I'm gonna use a rotating cake tray. If you don't have that, that's okay. You can use a regular or you can use a plate. All right, time to get this out. All right. Now I'm gonna take a bit of the top off so we can have an evenly balanced layer. I'm gonna use what I call the Boston cream pie method. No one else calls it, I don't think, I'm just making it up. You poke holes in the sides of the cake to help with the cutting process. Okay, that should be enough. grab a knife, make sure it's sharp enough, and gently go side to side. Climb the top of the cake. Now, you could do whatever you want with that top part. I might have keep it as a sample cake for my friends and family to try. Alright, a couple edges are off, but that is okay.
Now,
I'm gonna carefully add the strawberry preserves.
I'm gonna grab my spatula, so come with me. Or you know what?
If you don't have your spatula handy, improvise and use a spoon, like this one. Depending on how big or small your cake is, I wouldn't recommend adding a lot, like I just did. Sorry, I had to stop the video for a minute so I can clean up a little bit. Maybe not pour directly, maybe like spoon it like so. I apologize. I thank you all for being incredibly patient. Sorry, I love listening to music when I cook or bake. It definitely helps me move along and stuff, keeps me focused and everything. Now, if you have any extra preserves anywhere, find a nice jar and just store it. This one because it's flat enough. This one looks sure I scooped it out properly. And the other day, next place, same. So I'm just gonna zip my hand real quick. And,
thank you for coming out. It is great to be
probably
here.
Probably should have mentioned this. I apologize, that was a Jim Gaffigan thing. Anyway, I forgot to warn you about this. Please make sure your bottom, maybe the strawberry preserves are not so sticky. Alright. And I am also going to cut the bottom of this because I have a feeling it's not going to be that appetizing eating the bottom. Hopefully I'll do a better job. And don't worry, my hands are totally clean, I promise. Gently slide back and forth. You may have to turn it a little bit in case the hole gets the top or bottom. Okay. This, and shave a little more off the top. Bottom layer. gently place it on top like so. Okay. It's here. And time to frost. Now, you'll want to move it all around, but what I'm going to do is be careful for one thing. And something that I've seen a lot on YouTube, you place it right here and just swirl. Now, full disclosure, I have never done this before, so. And don't worry, we are going to smooth all this out. Apologies, I am not good at this. I've never done this before, so. Okay, bear with me. Don't worry, everything's gonna get smoothed out like I. See how smooth and velvety it is? Now you're gonna take either another spatula or one of these. It's called a cake scraper. And you're gonna gently place over it. Okay, now I'm gonna attempt to transfer the cake onto this. That one doesn't go. All right, the key is to carefully get the bottom. You can use one spatula or two, literally doesn't matter. Okay. And there you have it. The Uncivil Warriors Anniversary Cake. Thank you so much for watching today's On the Spectrum Kitchen. And if you're watching this, I encourage you to watch the Three Stooges Uncivil Warriors in honor of their 88th anniversary today. If you like what you saw, hit that like button, comment, and if you want to see more, subscribe to this channel. Have a good day, everybody. Bye.